Welcome everybody on Facebook for an evening in the supernatural, and welcome everybody on the conference call tonight. I'll be your host tonight. My name is Martiel Swanko, and my assistant will be Desiree Wood. So we welcome you to the Dynamic Prayer Network and Martiel Swanko Ministries Evening in the Supernatural. What we do every Monday is we pray for the sick, and sometimes we give a little mini teaching or a word of encouragement for those that may be facing a healing situation where they need to be healed. As Christians and as people in the body of Christ, as believers, the Bible says to lay hands on the sick and they shall recover. So all of us as believers have a responsibility to pray for the sick. So that's why we're here on Facebook. We want to open up the opportunity to be able to pray for people that need healing. Maybe some of you on the conference call tonight came on because you need a healing, or maybe you know somebody that does. For those of you that are on Facebook, if you know anyone that may need prayer for healing, please share the video with your friends so that if anyone does have pain or sickness, we can pray for them tonight, because that's what we're here. That's what we're here for. We want to have an outreach to the community so people could see that people care, that people are here to pray for them. Not everybody knows how to get prayer for healing. I mean, some churches don't pray for healing during a church service. Sometimes people don't believe and they're sick and they never even thought of praying and they don't know where to go to. So we figured we'd just become live on Facebook and let people see that there are people that pray today. So we're doing it as a service, as an outreach to reach out to all of you that come out on the conference call on Monday night, and also to reach out to more people through Facebook. So we welcome everybody. All right. So let's see. Okay. So I'm not sure if there's anybody. Is there anybody? This is your first time tonight on the conference call? Okay. I assume everyone's been here before. Okay. Well, awesome. That's,
amen.
That's, is there somebody new?
Yeah, I'm new.
Okay, so.
This is my first Monday.
Okay, let me just take one at a time because it's hard to hear everybody. I think it was Sarah from Pennsylvania. Did you say something?
Yes, Sarah. I'm new on the prayer line.
Okay.
It's my first time tonight.
And how'd you hear about it, Sarah?
I was just Googling, I was checking for a prayer line on the, for prayers on the internet.
Okay.
And I came across this your website.
Okay, and you were doing that today?
No, I did it last week on Thursday, then I sent in a prayer request.
Oh, okay, awesome, awesome, well, welcome. And was there anybody else that was new? This is your first time?
Thank you.
Yes, this is my first Monday.
This is your first Monday? Okay, well, great. Awesome. Well, welcome. We'd love to have you. And was it Tina from Maryland? Were you? Is this your first time as well?
This is my first Monday, but it's not my first time. I started last week.
Oh, okay. All right. Well, we do have, just to let everyone know, on Monday we pray. It's our evening in the supernatural where we pray for the sick. And we always have prayer Monday through Friday. That is 8 p.m. to 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. And then on Monday, we pray for the sick. On Wednesday, we have college classes. And on Friday, we have our church service. So, and that's for people that don't have a church or maybe they're traveling. We offer that service as well on a Friday. So anyway, so welcome everybody. So what we do on Friday night is every night's a little bit different, but what I wanted to do tonight is some of you might be facing a sickness and some of you may know somebody facing a sickness. And sometimes we don't know what to do. Some people don't know how to pray. Some people do know how to pray. Some people don't know how to pray for their friends. They might know how to pray for themselves, but they don't know how to pray for their friends. And so what I wanted to do tonight is just to go over what the Word of God says. When somebody's sick, if we know somebody that's sick, what do we do? Well, the Bible's clear. The Bible says to, he says in the Word, he says to decree a thing and it'll be so. And God also tells us to put him in remembrance of his Word. So we're supposed to put him in remembrance of what the Word says. And God says in his Word, one of the things that comes to my mind, the scripture that most of us know about healing, is that believers shall lay hands on the sick and they shall recover. He says all believers, you know, not some, not particular ones, not those that have been saved for their whole life or those that just got saved, but he just says believers, people that believe in Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior, believers. That's you and I. We're the ones called to pray for the sick. We're called to do a lot of other things too, but one of the things that sometimes people don't realize is we're all called to pray for the sick. Some of us have even greater anointings and healings than others. I'm going to go ahead and mute the call just to make it easier for us to be able to hear.
All participants are muted.
And then I will unmute it as we go to pray for people. But sometimes we don't realize that we're all called to pray for the sick. And some of us even have a greater calling to pray for the sick because we have a strong anointing or gifting to pray for the sick. I'm one of those people. The day I gave my life to the Lord, although I was raised in the church my whole life, but I never knew I was supposed to give him my life. I figured that out or found that out when I was 17 in high school. And so I gave my life to the Lord then. And it was then when I started reading the Bible that I realized I was supposed to pray for the sick. It wasn't just the priest that was supposed to pray for the sick, but it was all believers were to pray for the sick. So I realized then I was supposed to pray for the sick. So I just started praying for the sick. Whoever was sick, I'd pray for them. I wanted them to see that God was real because the Bible says signs and wonders are for unbelievers. So I just took it upon myself to pray for as many people as I could because I wanted to make sure that people knew that God was real. You know, people are never going to know God's real unless we show them that he's real or that they can see the power in God. And so sometimes you can't see that power unless somebody prays for you or somebody, one of your friends might be not only praying for you, but maybe somebody comes along and shows you how to pray, but then you see the power of God show up. So we don't know unless believers are out praying for the sick. And so all of us have that responsibility. And God says in his word that believers will lay hands on the sick, and it says, and they shall recover. It doesn't say sometimes. It doesn't say maybe. It doesn't say if you've prayed up enough, if you're old enough in the Lord, if you've read your Bible, if you know the Bible. It doesn't say any of that. It just says believers. Those are people that believe in Jesus Christ. They believe that Jesus, because he died on the cross and he rose from the dead, we have an inheritance as children of the Most High God to have that same authority that Jesus had that he imparted to the disciples. You know, the first church and the disciples, what did they do? They went around two by two, and you hear all the miracles in the Bible where their shadow touched people and they were healed, or they laid hands on people and they were healed. How about the guy at the gate where they were going into the church, and they said, you know, he sat there sitting there for alms, and Peter said, gold and silver have I none, but such that I have I give to you, rise up and walk. And he took the man's hand, and poof, the guy got healed. And yet he was sitting at that gate for a long time. But the disciples decided to pray for him. The man didn't ask him for prayer, he was looking for alms. But they took it upon themselves to pray for him because they were believers and they've seen Jesus heal and they knew if Jesus could do it before, he could do it again. And they knew they had that power because they were disciples of Christ. And if we're believers and we're his disciples, we have that same power. God will show up when we pray for the sick too, but we have to step out. You know, sometimes if we don't step out, we don't see the power of God in action. A lot of times people will see, they'll know about God. They'll know the Bible's real. They'll know different things, what the Word of God says. But they don't really realize that God is doing miracles and really doing miracles today, just like he did with the first church. The 12 disciples went out. They got taught, and they went out doing signs and wonders. How did they do that? Because it was easy for them to do that once they saw Jesus doing them. And then they realized when he went to the cross that they were given that same authority. So you and I have that same authority. The same authority Christ had, we have because we're his children. Not because we did anything great, but because of what he did on the cross. We have that right. We have that authority as children of the Most High God. So we can pray for people in Jesus' name and see people healed. You just got to try it. You know, you just got to step out. And you've got to speak what the Word of God says, and God will honor his word. So that's what I'm doing tonight. We're going to speak the Word of God, And we're going to see God show up and pray for some people and see God, people get healed, because God's in the business of healing people. But he needs someone like me and someone like you to pray and see the miraculous and see him show up. So I want to pray a prayer tonight, just a little prayer before we get started. For you, some of you that have been here before, or some of you that might be familiar with the Bible, we all know that God says he can't forgive us unless we have forgiven others. And so we can't harbor any unforgiveness in our heart if we want God to forgive us. And at the same token, you can't have the power of God flowing through you like it could flow through you if you have sin in your life or unforgiveness. So we're just going to pray a prayer, and then we're going to go ahead and start to pray for some people, but we're going to go over some scriptures first. So I just want to pray first, because, you know, if we don't pray and ask God for his help, his power, we're doing it on our own, and it's not going to work. But when we come before the Lord and ask him to show up, then he shows up. And he says, when two or more are in agreement, it shall come to pass. And so because we're gathered in his name, he says, where there's two or more gathered in his name, he's in our midst. And we need God to show up, because God's the one with the power. He lives within us and we have his authority, but he's the one that chooses to turn the switch on or off. And I know God wants to heal people. That's why we're here on Facebook. And I know you all want to see God heal as well. And together, we're a powerful unit, because we are God's children, and he has given us the equipment that we need to pray for the sick. We have that right because we're children of the Most High God. And some of us have the gift of healing. Like, I have the gift of healing. It's been very strong for me ever since I got saved. Even at 17, when I'd pray for the sick, I would see people getting healed. I thought everybody prayed for the sick and everybody got healed, what I was seeing when I first got saved. But I came to realize I have a strong gift of healing. And there are a lot of people that have strong gifts of healing. Some of you on the prayer line tonight, you probably have it as well. But sometimes we have to activate that gift and start using it for it to develop. Just like when you go to the gym. You can't just go to the gym or not go to the gym and think you're going to have developed muscles. You have to lift weights, and you have to do things to develop your muscles and your strength so that you can become stronger and stronger. Same is true with our spiritual equipment that God gives us. We have to use it for it to be developed. So that's what we're doing tonight. So anyway, let's just pray a prayer. So Father, in Jesus' name, we come before you on behalf of everyone on the conference call tonight, Lord, and on Facebook. Father, we just lift everyone up tonight, Father, and I just thank you, Lord, that your power will flow through each one of us, Lord. Those that need healing, Father, that they will feel a touch from you. Father, that they will feel a strengthening. Father, those that have pain will be pain-free. And Father, those that are facing incurable diseases will be healed. Father, I thank you for the miraculous. Lord, you say in your word, Father, that we're to come boldly to your throne of grace to obtain mercy and help in time of need. So, Father, we're all coming boldly because we believe your word. We believe you. And, Father, we thank you that as we pray for the sick tonight, Lord, that you will show up. And, Father, that they will see that you are real. Father, they will feel your power and your strength. Father, I thank you that you are the great physician. Lord, that you are all-powerful. You're the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. And so, Father, I just thank you that as we pray tonight as believers, Lord, you say believers will lay hands on the sick and they shall recover. So, Father, I thank you that as we pray for the sick tonight, Lord, that they will recover because you will honor your word. Father, that you're faithful to perform your word, Lord, in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. All right, so we're going to go ahead and get into, I just wanted to go over some scriptures tonight. And then what we do tonight on Monday night is I usually do like a little mini teaching, or I go over some scriptures and then I pray for the people. So those of you that are on the conference call tonight, if you all, if any of you have pain or back pain or whatever it is that may be bothering you, we will definitely pray for you. And also those that are on Facebook, any of you that may have a need for healing, we'll be happy to pray for you as well. All right, so I'm going to go over a few scriptures tonight. How do we pray for the sick? That's how I started out this teaching tonight. How do we pray for the sick? Well, it's very easy. You take some healing scriptures from the Bible, and God says to decree his word, and he's going to bring it to pass. So we have to hang on to his promises, because as children of the Most High God, we've got promises. You know, just like our own parents, if they die, they come up with a last will and testament, and they give their belongings to their children. Well, that's all God did. He did it with the New Testament and an Old Testament. We're under the New Testament today. And as children of God, okay, he gave us his last will and testament, the Bible. So it'd be a good thing for all of us to read the book to realize what we inherit as his children. Because some of us don't know what we inherit. So God wants us to know what we inherit as his children. We're supposed to read the book. One of the promises is divine health. So what I do when I want to pray for the sick, or if I'm getting attacked myself with the flu or something, I'll read scriptures. You know, when you read the word is life. It says it's sharper than a two-edged sword. So when you speak the word, it's powerful. But sometimes we don't speak the word, so we don't get to see the power. But God wants us as children of God to speak his word. He says, put on the mind of Christ. That means let our thoughts and our tense and purposes be lined up to the word of God. We have to put on God's mind. What do I mean by that? Well, God doesn't want us to walk around sad and upset and negative all day. He wants us to be positive. He wants us to be happy. So we would do what the word of God says. The word of God says, let the joy of the Lord be your strength. So if you're walking around depressed all the time, the joy of the Lord is not your strength. So that's just an example how you have to put aside depression, if you're fighting depression, and speak the word over your life. Embrace what the word of God says. And believe it or not, eventually it will come to pass in your life, because God honors his word. But it's like I tell people, sometimes your spirit could be like a raisin, and your flesh or your flesh will be like a basketball. And you have to fill up your spirit with the word of God, so that raisin becomes the basketball and that basketball becomes the raisin, which is your flesh. So what do I mean by that? Well, as you speak the word and you decree the word and you line your life up with the word and it gets into your spirit, you start filling up your spirit. And pretty soon your spirit will trump all negative thoughts that come your way, because you have so much word in you that when something comes into your mind that's contrary to the word of God, you'll just cast it down. You won't even entertain the thought because you don't believe it. But if you believe the negative and that's all you're listening to all day long, that's because your flesh is in control of your spirit instead of your spirit being in control of your flesh. The word of God says that Christians are supposed to be spirit-led. Okay, that means being led by the Spirit of God, not by your emotions, not by your flesh. But most people are led by their flesh and their emotions. If you're led by the Spirit of God, the Bible says those that are led by the Spirit of God are the sons and daughters of God. So God wants us to be led by his Spirit, because that's where the power is. That's how he shows up in our life. He shows up honoring his word. He shows up when we conform to his word. I mean, if I'm out robbing a bank, God is not going to bless that. It's contrary to his word. That's just a simple example, but he's not going to honor that. Because I can't rob a bank and think I'm going to get the blessings of God in my life. But if I get a negative thought in my mind about depression and I cast it down and I say, Lord, give me the joy of the Lord. That's my strength. Lord, help me to see this situation the way you do. Well, God will do that and he'll change your eyes and all of a sudden you'll get to see what's really going on and it may not be as bad as you think it is. And so joy prevails in that situation instead of depression. Because you put that circumstance under submission to the word of God, okay? By submission to his spirit. And that's what God wants us to do. So if we submit to his word and we confess his word and we decree his word, the word will start to manifest in our lives. And pretty soon our spirits will be like a basketball and our flesh will be like a raisin. And so what do I mean by that? Well, when you have a sickness, you're going to be able to speak the word. And the word is going to come to pass, because you're not going to have a wishy-washiness. You're not going to have your flesh taking over saying, oh, you're never going to get healed. Don't you feel that pain? You're in pain because your mother had the same arthritis that you have. You're never going to get healed. Well, we're under a new covenant. When we receive Christ, we're under Christ's covenant. We're under his genes. His genes are healthy and whole. His contract is that we have divine health. That's what the Bible says, okay? But if we're not operating in divine health or we're not living in divine health, we need to keep speaking the word until our bodies line up to divine health, okay? It doesn't just happen overnight. You got to fight for it. But that's what we need to do. Okay, so I'm seeing that my Facebook live session, I have to plug my cord in because my phone is dying. So just 1 minute. All right. All right, there we go. Sorry about that. Okay, so what we want to do is we want to speak the word. So let me just give you a few scriptures that if you're believing God for a healing and you need some scriptures, here's some examples of how you can pray for yourself to get better or pray for somebody in your family or anybody that you know for that matter. Okay, Exodus 15:26. It says, saying, if you will diligently hearken to the voice of the Lord your God and will do what is right in his sight, and will listen to and obey his commandments and keep all his statutes, I will put none of the diseases upon you which I brought upon the Egyptians, for I am the Lord who heals you. Okay, that's just a simple scripture that talks about how if we listen, diligently listen to the voice of the Lord our God, and we do what's right in his sight. Obviously, we can't go around robbing banks and think God's going to heal us, because then we have sin in our life. God wants us to live a righteous and holy life as best as we can, and we'll be able to have what he, you know, his promises. We'll be able to inherit them. Okay, Exodus 23:25. You shall serve the Lord your God. He shall bless your bread and water, and I will take sickness from your midst. So there's many scriptures in the Bible where God talks about taking sickness from our lives. How about the Lord's Prayer? Everybody knows the Lord's Prayer. It says, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Okay, that's a simple prayer. It's in the New Testament. And God promises, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. And we all know there's no sickness in heaven. So God wants us well on earth. But a lot of times we don't live in that health that God intends for us to live in because we don't take care of our bodies. We don't work out. We don't take vitamins. We don't eat right. We don't use wisdom. And then we want God to heal our bodies. At the same time, a lot of times people will just accept the sickness that comes in their body and say, well, my grandmother had it, so I'm going to get it too. I've had diabetes in my family for 4 generations, so I'm going to get it too. Well, you don't have to have diabetes because you're under a new covenant. But if you want to have it and you keep speaking like that and coming in agreement with it, you definitely will get it because the Bible's very clear. If you come into agreement, okay, there's power with that. But you don't want to come into agreement with that because you're under a new covenant. You want to come into agreement with the Word of God, okay? And he says he'll take sickness from our midst. He says believers will lay hands on the sick and they'll recover. He says, I wish above all things that thou mayest prosper and be in health, even as your soul prospers. So he wants us well. But if we don't know the Word, we'll accept the sickness. And we'll take part in that. And we'll speak a sickness into our life and come into agreement with that, because that's all we know. We don't know the word. So we start saying things that's contrary to the word of God, but God wants us to come into alignment with his word. So I always tell everyone, you want to know what the word of God says about healing? Google it. Google scriptures on healing and see how many of them come up and speak that over your life. Google scriptures on health, faith. So that you can see the scriptures that are there that you can come into agreement with. Because if you don't come into agreement with the Word of God, you have no power. The power is in the Word of God. So we need to speak the Word of God, and our lives need to come into agreement with that. But how can we come into agreement with this if we don't know what it says? How many of us have actually read the Bible? So we've got to know what our contract states, what our covenant states. So we need to take part in it and start reading it. Amen? All right, so I'm going to give you a few more scriptures that are healing scriptures, and then I'll give you some faith scriptures. Okay, it says in Psalm 89:34, it says, my covenant will I not break, nor alter the thing that has gone out of my lips. Thank God we serve a God that honors his word, and he does. So he's telling us, my covenant will I not break, nor alter the thing that has gone out of my lips. Well, his covenant with us is divine health. And he says, he wishes above all things that thou mayest prosper. That's you and that's me. That you and I will prosper and be in health even as our souls prosper. So God wants us well. But we have to know what the Word of God says. And we have to speak the Word of God and come into alignment with what the Word of God says. He says in Psalm 91:16, which I love this scripture. He says, with long life will I satisfy him and show him my salvation. So God wants to show us long life. And he wants to show us his salvation. So God wants the best for us, just like our parents do. God wants the best for us. And he wants to satisfy us. So he will give us long life. But again, he's going to give us long life when we line our lives up to his word. I mean, if we are out drinking and smoking and eating terribly and so forth and living in unforgiveness, well, that doesn't make for a good long life. I can tell you that. That makes for a lot of trouble. And we have to do the right thing. But if you do the right thing, then you can petition heaven for your healing, because God wants you well. He says in Psalm 103:3, for who forgives all your iniquities, who heals all your diseases. So God forgives all of our iniquities and he heals each one of our diseases. That's what it says in Psalm 103:3. So it's his will for us to be healed. We just need to know what the book says, and we have to stand in agreement and we have to decree it. Now, the good thing about Monday nights is I think tonight we've got 19 people on our conference call and we've got people on Facebook. So all of us are in agreement for, God's healing power to move. So God moves when there's numbers, when we're all in agreement, there's power and God shows up. So it's exciting. Tonight will be a powerful night because we've got 19 people believing by faith and stretching their faith out for people to believe on the conference call. And then we've got people on Facebook as well. So let's all just continue to believe and trust God and remind him of his word. Okay, he says in Psalm 105:37, he brought them forth also with silver and gold, and there was not one feeble person among the tribes. Now that's another one of my favorite, because the Israelites were out there for 40 years, and it says there wasn't one feeble person among the tribes. He kept them all well. So why can't God keep us well today? He can. But if we believe the lie that we're supposed to be sick, then we're going to be sick. But if we believe what the Word of God says, then we could be well. But we sometimes have to command our bodies to come into alignment. We sometimes have to make dietary changes to get our bodies back to where they should be, because we haven't been taking care of them. And we wonder why we're sick. Well, we're sick because we didn't follow the book. And so therefore, sickness was able to come in. But we can get it back, because God promises us that we can come to his throne and ask him to forgive us, and he'll help us. So one of the things I always tell people is, pray for wisdom. Ask God to show you how to get better. He can show you. Maybe you're allergic to some type of food. Maybe you have unforgiveness in your heart. Maybe you were abused as a child and you don't realize that's affecting your health. I can go on and on. The point is, we need to ask God for wisdom, and we need to speak the word. We need to declare it over our lives, and we need to renew our minds with the word of God. That's how you get well. Now, how do you pray for someone that's sick? You take the word of God, you do what the Bible says. It says believers will lay hands on the sick and they shall recover. So we're believers. So as we pray tonight, we can lay hands by the Spirit, you know, in the Spirit, okay, because we're all together and one in the Spirit, we're one. Okay, so we can lay hands in the Spirit on somebody by faith and speak the word, and God will show up because he's going to honor his word. But that's how you pray for someone. You get scriptures and you stand on the word. I've said this before and I'll say it again. One time I was in a meeting and people were praying for people in English. And when they prayed for people in English, you just saw people praying for people in English, and it wasn't anything supernatural in the spirit, when you could see in the spirit. But there were other people that when they spoke the word of God, you would see fire coming out of their mouths. So when you speak the word, it's like fire. It's really powerful. And so it's best to speak the word when you're wanting to get healed or pray for someone, because the word, the Bible says the word of God never returns void. It's powerful and sharper than a two-edged sword. So that's powerful. If you speak the word, God is going to honor it. Now, it's going to be in his timing. Sometimes it's not our timing, but God will honor his word, and he's faithful and just to perform it, because that's what he says. So we just need to speak the word, decree a thing, and it is so. Speak the word, and God's word has power and life behind it. And as you speak it, you will see things will change. I don't have anything better than you do, except if I speak the word, there's power behind it. And together, as all of us come together in agreement, God shows up. So there's more power. Okay, let me just do a few more scriptures. All right, Jeremiah 30:17. It says, "For I will restore health to you." Now that's interesting. He says, "I will restore health to you." That means he knows that we're going to have bad health at times, or we're going to get attacked. Some people may be born with it. He says, "I will restore health to you, and I will heal your wounds." He doesn't say maybe. He doesn't say sometimes. He says, "I will heal your wounds," says the Lord, "because they have called you an outcast, saying, 'This is Zion, whom no one seeks after and for whom no one cares.'" Okay, the point is, the most important thing is, "For I will restore health to you, and I will heal your wounds," says the Lord. So God wants to restore our bodies, and he wants to heal our wounds. And he will. We just need to ask him. And we need to remind him of his word, because he tells us to remind him of his word. Okay. Hosea 4:6. It says, this is a good scripture. "My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge." Okay. "Because you have rejected knowledge, I will also reject you, that you shall be no priest to me. Seeing you have forgotten the law of God, I will also forget your children." Basically, what God is saying is, my people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. That's you and I. If we don't know the book, if we don't know what the book says, we could be destroyed for lack of knowledge. But if we know what the book says, we won't be destroyed. Well, we can know what the book says, but if we're not walking in it, then we can be destroyed. But God says, my people, that means Christians, people that profess Jesus, that probably go to church, my people are destroyed. His people, that's you and I, we could be destroyed for lack of knowledge. That means there must be a lot of people that don't read the book and don't conform to the book, because God wouldn't have put that in Hosea 4:6. My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. Okay? And then it goes on to say, because you, meaning the Christian nation, have rejected knowledge. So sometimes you and I reject God's knowledge, his wisdom, his truth. I'll give you an example. What if he says in the book, he tells us to take care of the temple? And we just say, I don't need to take care of the temple. I could do drugs. I could drink. I could stay up all night. I could eat whatever I want to eat. Well, eventually it catches up to you, as we all know. And eventually you get pretty sick. Well, that's because we rejected his knowledge, which was take care of the temple. Now, that's just a basic example. But he's saying, my people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. That means there's a lot of Christians that are walking around sick because they have lack of knowledge. And it doesn't just mean knowledge of the book, because that's part of it. But the knowledge of embracing the truth. We all know the truth. The Bible says the truth will set you free. But we know the truth, but then we don't, it's like we know it, but we don't know it. We don't have that revelation to understand, oh my God, I really need to do this because it's going to change my life. That's what I'm talking about. That kind of knowledge. It's the revelation of knowing this is important and I need to change my life in this area if I want to live a better life. You know, what does that old saying go? They say, what's insanity? Doing the same thing and expecting different results. Well, that's the same thing Christians do. They go to church all the time and this and that, and they think God's going to heal them, but yet they haven't changed any of their ways. They're still eating fried chicken. They're still not working out. They're still eating sugar. including myself. I have to get off sugar. And we have to change in order to be able to embrace the new that God has for us. I mean, He wants us well, but we can't get well unless we decide to make dietary changes that will be to our best interest. How many people know people that are sick with cancer? You know, the only way you get better with cancer is you got to get sugar out of your diet, because sugar feeds the cancer. Just like candida, sugar feeds candida. Well, you can't get better with cancer if you don't get the sugar out of your life. And that not only just, you know, cane sugar, but the sugar from carbs. Bread has sugar, you know, all these different things. So you have to make a choice to get better. And you need God to help you, because if we have a habit of that, it's difficult to change unless we have God's strength. So that's just an example. So my people are destroyed for lack of knowledge, because we've rejected knowledge. A lot of us reject knowledge and we don't even realize it. God can be speaking to us and we just don't see the truth. Like, I'll give you an example of myself. I remember a friend of mine telling me I needed HCL. And I would say, what do I need HCL for? Well, it helps you digest your food and you'll get most of the nutrients. Well, I know he told me this probably 10 years ago. I've had a couple people tell me, but I really didn't listen because I really didn't think I needed it. But then I found out I really need it, because our bodies don't make HCL as we get older. We make very little of it. And that's how most people die, because they don't have nutrition and they need HCL. Not only that, they need digestive enzymes to digest their food, because we don't make them as we get older like we used to in our 20s. So I should have listened back then, but I didn't. But now I'm realizing I really need to listen. And not only that, but I learned that HCL helps with your teeth. So you don't get the plaque on your teeth if you take HCL. Well, that sold me. I'm going to take HCL for the rest of my life. Why? Because I don't want that on my teeth. I want to have good, clean teeth, and I don't want dentures. But my point is, until you get the revelation of how important something is to you, you won't make that change. You won't make that decision. And so we all have to pray for God's wisdom, so God will give us His wisdom to see things His way, and then it'll be easy to make the change. So when it comes to healing, we can get healed praying for the sick and decreeing God's word. But we can also get healed by just making dietary changes, or sleeping more, you know, or eating better and so forth. We all have to incorporate everything to be able to keep our bodies. He says that we are required to keep, you know, to keep our temples holy, and to take care of our temples. So God wants to be able to call on us whenever, but He can't call on us if we're sick all the time. I remember one time, I'm remembering this one story I have where I was going to do a healing meeting, because I've been doing healing meetings my whole life. I love praying for the sick. So I remember doing a healing meeting. I don't know. I could have been 20, in my early 20s or something, at college or something. And I was going to do a healing meeting, but I got sick that day. And I remember going home and I had strep throat and I had to go to the hospital to get some shots. And then I got strep throat again, like 3 weeks later, and I was just so sick. And I remember saying to myself, gee, this is really good. I had this sign up, you know, healing meeting or prayer for the sick, you know, at such and such a date. And I remember laughing in my bed when I was sick, saying, well, this ought to be great. I'll put a big X over the sign, you know, for healing meeting, and I'll put canceled due to sickness. How crazy is that? But you know what? That's kind of how it is with Christians. We're getting sick a lot because we're not taking care of ourselves, and yet we want God to heal us. And God wants us to start being proactive. He wants us to take a proactive approach to getting better. Remember, 2/3 of God's name is go. We've got to do our part, and He'll do His part. But He'll do His part, we just got to ask Him. So sometimes we've got to ask Him for His strength to help us do the things that we need to do. So anyway, here's a few more scriptures that I want to share, and then we'll start praying for the sick. But I want to share some of these with you, because those of you that might be facing a sickness right now, the Bible says when you hear the word of God, it builds your faith up. And when we speak the word, it releases power on the scene. So I love using scriptures, because scripture releases the power. Okay, Mark 16:18, it says, "And they," meaning Christians, "will pick up serpents, and if they drink any deadly thing, it will not hurt them. They will lay hands on the sick, and they will get well." So that's you and I. Christians are to lay hands on the sick, and they will get well. We're also commanded to do this, by the way. God, we are commanded as children of God to go around. We're supposed to be God's little children going around laying hands, because as I extend my hands to you or to you, I'm extending the hand of Jesus. And when I pray for you, it's easy for me to believe that God's going to heal you, because I don't see my hand when I pray for you. I see the hand of Jesus because he lives in me. And so I'm just his representative going around praying for the sick to get healed. And if you guys can do the same thing, and as we release our hands towards the people that we're praying, it's really we're releasing Jesus' hands. Because if we're Christians, we have the hands of Christ. We have his feet. We have his mouth. Okay? So he's going to show up and he's going to work through us, because we're all he has. He doesn't have a lot of people. So he's going to use who he can who he could use. All right. And then Luke 10:19, it says, "Behold, I have given you authority and power to trample on serpents and scorpions, over all the power of the enemy, and nothing shall in any way harm you." So God has given us the authority. There's the scripture right there. Authority and power to trample on the enemy. And we win. Nothing's supposed to harm us. So if we have sickness where the enemy, because the Bible says the devil's out to kill, steal, and destroy us. So we need to combat the enemy with the word of God. So if he's out to kill, steal, and destroy us, it says right here that we've been given power over the enemy and nothing shall in any way harm us. So if he's trying to put sickness on us, we have to combat that and fight it with the word of God and start speaking the word of God towards that sickness. And eventually, it's going to win. Why? Because it's like a battery. If it takes 10 volts to start your car and you're only at 6 volts, your car's not going to start. But if you jump it and you put some juice in it, when it gets to 10 volts, it's going to start. Well, same is true with our faith. If we build up our faith, and our faith might be at 2 volts right now, and we need it at 10 volts to receive our healing, the more faith we pour into ourselves, the more scriptures we read, the more times we're in God's presence, the anointing with other believers and so forth, that continues to build up your battery, your faith battery, to get to that 10 volts to where you can receive your healing. But sometimes we've got to build up. And then sometimes God just heals us. Miraculously, he just heals us when we've done absolutely nothing and we don't even deserve it. He just poof shows up and you get healed and you're like amazed. You know, God is just this, God is a loving God, and we never know what God can do because he's capable of doing anything. But we do know what the word of God says. And if we go by what the word of God says, God will honor his word. It says in John 9:31, "We know that God does not listen to sinners." I mean, he listens to them, obviously. He listens to everyone. He says, "My sheep know my voice." So we all, obviously the other ones hear his voice, but they may not know his voice if you're a sinner. But it says, "We know that God does not listen to sinners. But if anyone is God-fearing and a worshiper of him and does his will, he listens to him." What it's really saying here is God hears everybody, but he can't answer a sinner's prayer if you have sin in your life, because then that's contrary to the book, okay? And God follows the book. He's the judge of the universe, and Jesus, his son, is our advocate. He's our attorney in the courtroom of heaven fighting for you and I to receive our healing. But if you have sin in your life, then God can't answer. He can't answer it because it violates his covenant. It violates his contract, and God's not going to violate his contract because he honors his word. Okay, so it says, but you and I were Christians. It says, "We know that God does not listen to sinners." Okay, but if anyone is God-fearing and a worshiper of him and does his will, meaning follows the book, he listens to him. So that means God hears our prayers. Amen. He also hears prayers of those people that are not Christians, because he says signs and wonders are for unbelievers. So he shows up. It rains on the just and the unjust, as the Bible says. All right. And the scripture I told you earlier, I just want to tell you what it was. It was John 10:10. "The thief comes only in order to steal, kill, and destroy. So that's why the devil's on earth. He's out to kill you, steal, and destroy you. That's what he wants to do because we're in God's image. He hates us. But God says that Jesus came that they might have life and have it in abundance or till it overflows. So God wants us as Christians to live the abundant life. He doesn't want us to be destroyed in our health with sickness. He doesn't want us to be stolen from, our health stolen from us, or for us to die early. He says he blesses us with long life. He says, with long life will I satisfy you and show you my salvation. But he also says that that we're supposed to have life and have it in abundance. And that goes for healing. So tonight when we pray, I want everyone to remember these scriptures that we've gone over, that the word of God is true, that God will honor his word. He says in 2 Corinthians 1:20, for as many as are the promises of God, they all find their yes in him. In other words, he honors them. Okay? They're yes and amen. Thank God he honors his word. All right, so we're going to pray tonight. And believe for those that need healing to be healed. Now, before I get started, I just want to go over a few things. Again, anyone on Facebook that may need a healing tonight, you can IM us and we'll pray for you. And those of you in our conference call tonight, I've got our students on tonight that will be praying as well with me to those people that need a healing touch. We've got Kavita, Aaron, Joshua, Desiree, Rick, and Peter Gay. So if you guys can all help me pray for our guest tonight, that would be great. Again, this is the body of Christ coming together to pray for the body of Christ. So we're here offering a service to everybody on Facebook as well as in our conference call. And we're here to just pray for those that need a healing. So if you have any friends that need prayer for healing, please have them come on because God does lots of miracles on Monday nights. On the conference call tonight, I'm going to go ahead and let's see. We're going to pray for a couple people. And then Joshua, if you're still on, Pastor Joshua, you could take up the offering. All right, so I want to just unmute the phone for a minute.
All participants are unmuted.
Is there anyone on the call tonight that may be in pain right now where I could pray for you? Does anyone have any pain right now, experiencing pain at this moment?
On my right hip.
Okay, is that Tina from Maryland?
Yes.
Okay, all right, so I'm going to pray for Tina first. Actually, we all are going to pray for Tina. And for the team members, also, when we're praying for her for healing, if any of you receive any words of encouragement for God, please press in for Tina and see what you get so we can minister to her. And if anyone on Facebook tonight, if you have a need for prayer, please let us know, IM us, and we'll be happy to pray for you. Okay, so Tina, you have pain, you said, in your hip right now?
Right hip, yes.
Okay, and what is the pain from? Do you know? Did you just fall or hurt yourself?
I don't know. It's there.
Okay, all right, so you have, no problem, you have pain in your hip. So what I want you to do is I'm going to pray for you, and after I pray for you, I just want you to do something you couldn't do before, and then you tell me if the pain's gone, okay?
Okay.
All right, so just put your hand on your right hip as a point of contact for us, okay? Because the Bible says lay hands on the sick. So I'm letting you lay hands on yourself, and we're going to lay hands on you by the Spirit, okay? All right, so team, everybody on Facebook, and for those of you that are on the conference call tonight, let's go ahead and lift up Tina right now. Father, in Jesus' name, Lord, I just lift up Tina right now, and I ask you, Father, to just to heal her hips. We command her hips and her sacrum to go into perfect alignment right now in the name of Jesus. Father, we command her vertebrae and disc to go into alignment in the name of Jesus. We command all soreness and all pain to go in Jesus' name. We command her muscles to relax. We command all pressure to go in the name of Jesus. Now, Tina, I'd just like for you to just say, thank you, Jesus, for healing me by faith.
Thank you, Jesus, for healing me. Thank you for your mercy, oh Lord.
Yes, and go ahead and just move around and tell me if the pain's gone. How do you feel?
Well, right this minute, I don't feel it.
Okay, so praise God. So you said, say that again, a little bit louder.
Right this minute, I don't feel it.
All right, so Tina says right this minute she doesn't feel it. Well, Tina, we're going to believe that you are healed. So I just want you to say, thank you, Jesus, for healing my hip.
Thank you, Jesus, for healing my hip. Thank you, Lord.
And we believe it's not going to come back. Amen?
Amen.
All right, we're speaking faith. Now, Tina, just 1 second. If anyone on the team has anything for Tina when you prayed for her, if anyone got anything and would like to speak it out, go ahead. Any students get anything for Tina? Okay, well, I got something. Tina, I feel like you're under a lot of pressure in your life right now, and I just want to pray for that. Is that correct?
Yes.
Okay, I just feel a strong pressure on you, so I just want to pray for that. Father, in Jesus' name, I just command the pressure in Tina's life to lift from her, Lord. I ask you, Lord, you say that you will to put all our cares upon you because you care for us. So, Father, I just thank you that Tina places her cares at the feet of Jesus. And, Father, she trusts that you are taking care of everything, that she's in good hands, Lord, not with Allstate, but she's in good hands with the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. And, Father, I thank you that all pressure, that pressure that's just that heaviness, Lord, we break that over her right now and we lift it from her in Jesus' name. And Father, your word says, whom the Son sets free is free indeed. So Father, we speak freedom from that pressure in Jesus' name.
Yes, sir. In Jesus' name.
Tina, Amen. Just move around and just tell me if that pressure's gone. I had felt a heaviness on you. I don't know if that's what you feel like, but is it gone?
Yeah, this happiness is in my heart.
Okay, it's in your heart? Is it still in your heart or what?
No, I don't know. It comes and goes. I'm not sure about that.
Okay. Do you have anyone that you might have unforgiveness towards?
No, my daughter passed away.
Okay, I thought it was grief. Okay, I felt grief, but I wasn't sure. Okay. So, Father, we just thank you for helping Tina through the grief. Father, for filling the void in her heart. Father, for making her whole. And, Father, we thank you that you love Tina more than anyone. And, Father, I thank you that she feels your love even right now, Father, that she feels your presence. And, Father, in your presence is fullness of joy. So, Father, we thank you for just the fullness of joy surrounding Tina and your love. In Jesus' name, amen.
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 This is Desiree.
Go ahead, Desiree.
And I saw on the line just this long clothesline filled with white linens in the breeze. And so I just want to just thank the Lord for new linens and making things clean and airy for you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. All right. Go ahead, Joshua.
Yes. What I saw is your basically your head, your mind.
Joshua, it's hard to hear you. I'm sorry, it's hard to hear you.
Oh, dear. How about now?
Yes, we can hear you now. Go ahead. Yes.
Okay. Yeah, what I saw was your mind. Just your mindset. So just like you turn the microwave to a certain setting. Those old microwaves that you just turn, you are, whatever setting you turn it to, that's how long it's going to, the heat is going to be produced from the microwave. Now, I feel like there are pressures and stresses that have mounted over time. Yeah, but we have to set our mind to stand against them and take action against them and release them, lose them from our souls and not allow them to stay in the name of Jesus. So we just bless you in the name of Jesus. And we declare in Jesus' name, these things are washed out by the washing of the water, by the word of God, that these stresses, they go from you in Jesus' name. and that they are washed away by the washing of water by the word. All long-standing stresses removed from you in Jesus' name.
Amen. Did you hear that okay, Tina?
Yes.
Okay, thank awesome. You, awesome.
Thank you.
All right, God bless you. Anybody else have pain on the line tonight that needs prayer?
Sarah in Pennsylvania.
Okay. Sarah, just hold that thought real quick because I forgot we always take up the offering and then we pray for the sick. So Joshua, Pastor Joshua, can you take up the offering tonight?
Yes, sure.
All right, if you could just make it quick because we're running a few, we're running late.
Okay, all right. Okay. Yes, sorry. The Word of God says that we should honor the Lord. That we should honor the Lord with our substance. Honor the Lord with thy substance and with the first fruits of all thy increase. So shall your barn be filled with plenty, and your presses shall burst out with new wine. In the name of Jesus, tonight we come and we receive this offering and we honor the Lord. In the name of Jesus, we say our heart is with the Lord, and so we give our treasure to the Lord in the name of Jesus. And we release rapid blessing. Rapid blessing. I say rapid blessing. Accelerated blessing. In the name of Jesus, we release accelerated blessing into the life of each and everyone. Accelerated blessing on every hand in the name of Jesus. And on the hands of the people who are giving or desire to give tonight in the name of Jesus. Accelerated blessing is yours in the name of Jesus. Financial problems are broken now in the name of Jesus. Financial bondages are broken now in the name of Jesus. Unjust financial contracts are broken now in the name of Jesus. And we decree the end of debt in the name of Jesus. We decree debt, all debt paid for, paid off in the name of Jesus. Eliminated in the name of Jesus. And we bless God, people, for this freedom, this liberty that he has released in our finances tonight in Jesus' name. Amen. Go to dynamicprayer.net and give. Click on give, and we can give with the Stripe service.
It's Stripe or PayPal. What Joshua is saying is, I think PayPal's still not working, so you'd have to give with Stripe, but it's www.dynamicprayer.net/donation, or you could just press on the give button at Dynamic Prayer. But I believe you'll have to give with Stripe tonight, because I don't think they fixed the PayPal button yet. There's something wrong with it. Okay, so thank you all in advance for giving. We appreciate it. You're helping us help more people like you. So awesome. Okay, so we're going to get back to healing. Now, there was somebody that had asked me earlier, who was that I was going to pray for?
Sarah.
Sarah in Pennsylvania. Okay. Where are you in Pennsylvania, Sarah?
Hatboro.
Is that by Pittsburgh or Philadelphia?
I'm in Hatboro. Yeah.
Okay. All right. All right, so what's wrong, Sylvia? Sarah?
Sarah.
Mine is not the pain as such, but every time when I go to bed, as soon as I get in bed, my throat dries up, and it dries up so much that it's hard for me to fall asleep. I have to kind of like eat candy and gum to moisten my throat.
Okay. I know there's things that cause dry mouth. Rick, are you on tonight? You have any suggestions, Rick? Health suggestions? Well, you're on mute, Ricky, so I can't hear you. You'd have to unmute yourself.
I have a suggestion. Are you dehydrated? Do you drink water during the day?
Lots of water. I take like 8 glasses or more every day.
But do you drink coffee and tea?
I don't drink coffee. I don't drink coffee once in a long time. I drink tea sometimes.
Because tea sometimes dehydrates you. If you drink a cup of water, then or drink a cup of tea, then you have to drink water because it takes a cup of water out of you. Just to let you know.
Are you diabetic?
No, I'm not.
Okay,
are
well, we're
you sure.
What was your A1C the last time you checked?
You may want to check if you're diabetic. That's why you drink a lot of water and your throat is dry. I want to check.
Go ahead, Joshua.
Yes. Have your A1C checked for diabetes? And also, when is the last time you had a colonoscopy?
I've never had
it. You've never? How old are you?
47.
Okay, well, you're coming up on 50. Well, talk to your doctor, give your doctor. When's the last time you went to the doctor?
In December.
Okay, you told him about the drive-through and all that?
No, I didn't have the problem at the time.
Oh, you didn't have it at that time. Okay, take it up with your doctor, but we will pray tonight. Yes. And this really thing, you will see it no more. In Jesus' name.
Yes, let's all be in agreement. All right, so just to let you know, Pastor Joshua is a nurse, so he was just giving you some advice from what he knows. Okay, so let's just pray for her. Father, in Jesus' name, I just lift up my sister Sarah. And Father, I just thank you, Lord, for healing the dry mouth, Lord. I thank you, Father, for healing every organ, every tissue, every muscle, every cell affiliated with this situation, Father. We just speak healing and a creative miracle for Sarah right now in the name of Jesus.
Jesus.
Father, we command healing to her body, wholeness to her body. And Father, I declare and decree that tonight she will sleep soundly with no complications. And Father, that she will have that praise report for us in the name of Jesus, Lord.
Oh, Jesus.
You are the great physician. So, Father, we thank you for healing and restoring her in Jesus' name. Sarah, can you take a couple of swallows and just say, thank you, Jesus, for healing me?
Thank you, Jesus, for healing me.
And can you take a couple swallows? Do you feel any different or you can't tell?
My mouth is dry.
Your mouth is dry?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, you keep me posted then, okay?
Yeah. Thank you.
You're welcome. All right. Is there anyone else that need a prayer tonight for healing? Anybody on Facebook? Who is that?
Hi, it's Roseanne.
Oh, hey, Roseanne. What can I do for you?
I actually need a healing for my cousin.
Okay.
For myself.
Okay.
She was just diagnosed with cancer.
Okay.
At stage 3 or 4. And so I would like to do a healing for her.
Okay, sure. Just so you know, sugar feeds cancer, so just make sure you let her know that. Watch the diet.
Right.
All right. So Father, in Jesus' name, we just lift up Roseanne's cousin. And Father, we curse the spirit of cancer in her body. Is it a her?
It is.
Okay. We curse the spirit of cancer in her cousin right now in Jesus' name. Father, we command every cancer cell in that body to die at the seed and root in Jesus' name. We cast it out of her. And Father, we thank you for a strong immune system. Father, we thank you her body will fight off this cancer once and for all, and we declare and decree that she is healed and made whole, that her body is strengthened in Jesus' name. And Father, we thank you for the testimony for Roseanne's cousin, Lord, that she will give us a testimony that she is cancer-free in Jesus' name. And everyone said, amen.
Thank you.
All right. Praise God.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Anybody else need prayer tonight? Anybody on
prayer?
Anxiety.
I had a A1C reading on February 22nd.
Okay, Deborah, hang on for a sec. There was somebody else that spoke up, and I'm not sure who that was. It was a man, I think.
It was Philip.
Okay.
I need prayer for this self-anxiety. It's driving me crazy.
For anxiety?
Yes. It hits me in the middle of the day and depression.
Okay, well, anxiety is fear. So we're going to cast out a spirit of fear, okay? I don't know what you're afraid of, but the Bible says that that fear, perfect love, cast out fear. So we're going to pray for that, and we're going to believe that God's going to fill you with faith, okay? So one thing I can tell you is there's a scripture in Philippians 4, 6 through 8. It says, do not fret or have any anxiety about anything, but in every circumstance, I'm sure you know the scripture, and in everything by prayer and petition with thanksgiving, make your wants known to God, and God's peace that passes all understanding will fill your heart, right? So God will, we're going to pray and decree that over you tonight, okay? And I just want to cast the spirit of fear out, because I think a spirit of fear entered you somewhere, and then it's just grown because you might have entertained the thoughts of that fear. Okay.
Yes.
Did you have, let me ask you, when you had this anxiety start in your life, what was happening? When did this anxiety start in your life?
About a year ago.
Okay. A year ago, prior to that, just prior to that year, when that was starting, what happened to you? What type of an emotional trauma?
I have been going to the hospital having chest pain, and they never could find out what was wrong with me. Never could find out. They ran a $1 million worth of tests. And they never found anything.
Because it's a spirit of fear. And when you have a spirit of fear in you and you entertain the thought like the devil's chattering in your ears telling you, you're going to die, Philip. That's what's going on. You're going to die. And if you entertain those thoughts, that's what he wants. And so it's keeping the fear instead of getting rid of it. You know what I mean? Let me just pray for you. Father, in the name of Jesus, okay, team, everybody on this prayer line, everybody on Facebook, Christians, please let's pray for Philip right now to get rid of this fear. So, Father, in Jesus' name, we just speak to the spirit of fear on the inside of Philip right now, Lord. However that fear got to him, Father, we curse it. We command it to come out of Philip now in Jesus' name. Every spirit of trauma that entered him when he went into those hospitals, we command those spirits to go now in Jesus' name. And Father, we command all anxiety and fear to leave his body, all depression. And Father, we fill it with your love, your faith, your joy, your comfort in Jesus' name. And Father, we decree from this day forward that he will not have another anxiety attack or fear. But Father, that he, if the enemy rises up to try to put fear on Philip again, that he will cast it down by the authority of Jesus, and he will speak the word of God over the situation. And the enemy will realize he's been defeated. He can no longer use this tactic on Philip again. In the name of Jesus. And we all stand in agreement with our brother Philip, and we said, Amen.
Thank you. Amen. Thank you.
Hey,
Amen.
Philip, do me a favor. Just say, I'm free in Jesus' name.
I'm free in Jesus' name.
Spirit of fear, you got to go.
Spirit of fear, you got to go.
In Jesus' name. Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Keep us posted, Philip.
Amen. I certainly will. Thank you all very much.
You're welcome. You're welcome. Okay, any of the team get anything for Philip? If any of the team is picking up anything, please let me know. You're welcome to speak out.
This is Joshua.
Pastor Joshua, go ahead.
Yes, I feel the love of God being released to Brother Philip in washing over him. And the Bible says, perfect love casts out fear.
Amen.
In Jesus' name, amen.
Yeah, Philip, you might want to listen to a lot of scriptures or find scriptures on love and you know, record them and then just play them over and over and let them play over and over because that will help as well.
Okay, I've written down all the scriptures that you gave out tonight as well.
Okay, well, good. You're such a good student. I'm glad to see that you actually listen to the teaching. I love it.
Yeah, I've written them all down.
All right. Like that. Okay, anybody else need prayer for healing tonight?
This Joshua also sees, him being healed.
Okay. Joshua says he sees you being healed in your heart.
Thank you. Amen.
This is Desiree. What I saw was his mouth. I saw his teeth and his mouth completely opened up and it was swiveling. And that, it's almost like that hinge where the mouth opens, where you can grind your teeth and cause that issue in the ear.
TMJ?
Yeah, the way I saw his mouth open, there was a release in that area.
Well, just pray it.
It's just like a release happened. Yes, yeah, amen.
Okay. All right, hallelujah. And anybody else need prayer for healing tonight?
Diabetes. My father falls from diabetes.
Okay, that's Deborah for diabetes?
Yeah.
Okay, is that for you? Is that for you, Deborah, or for your father?
No, my father passed when I was 15. I was shaving him. And he passed from diabetes, but right now I have type 2 diabetes.
Okay. All right. So let's pray for Deborah. Father, in the name of Jesus, I curse every generational curse of diabetes in Deborah's bloodline. And we break that assignment against her. Father, we thank you that she's covered by the blood of Jesus and that she's under the new covenant, Lord, your covenant, Lord, which is divine health, Lord, that she inherits divine health promises in Jesus' name. So, Father, we command the diabetes to go from her. We curse it, and we command her pancreas to function the way that's supposed to function. Lord, we just speak a new pancreas into Deborah's body right now in Jesus' name, and we command it to function with the rest of her body, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Supernatural health to come to Deborah. And, Father, we just speak strength into her body in the name of Jesus. And, Lord, your wisdom to guide and direct her in Jesus' name. And everyone said,
amen.
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 All right.
Thank you.
You're welcome. You're welcome. Anybody else need prayer for healing tonight?
When I'm driving in the freeway, it's every car is coming to run into me. Panic attack.
Panic attacks? Okay. Just one second. I'm just trying to...
In the freeway. I don't drive in the Beltway.
Okay. I'm just trying to see if anybody has a prayer request on Facebook, and I don't see any. So if anyone on Facebook has a prayer request and I somehow missed it, please let me know. I'm just trying to see if there is any prayer requests that have come in. Hello, everyone on Facebook. Hello, Pastor David from Texas. It's good to have you. And let's see, we've got Sharon from Port St. Lucie. Thank you for sharing this video, Sharon. And Deborah Gaynor, it's always a blessing to have you. And Anita, great to see you. All right, so if there's anyone in Facebook that needs prayer tonight, please post it. I don't see any at the present time, but I'll be happy to pray for you. All right, go ahead. Who was the person that said they needed prayer?
Panic attacks in the Beltway. I don't drive in the freeway.
All right, so you have panic attacks while you're driving. Okay, Tina. All right, so let's everyone pray for Tina right now. Father, in Jesus' name, Lord, we lift up your daughter, Tina. Father, your word says that every knee must bow to the name of Jesus, and that includes fear and anxiety. So, Father, I speak to the spirit of fear and anxiety in Tina, and I command it to go from her. In Jesus' name, I speak to the spirit of trauma in her body, Lord. The trauma that she has faced as a result of this, Lord, we speak to that spirit and we command it to get up and out of Tina now in Jesus' name. Now in Jesus' name. We release her from that trauma. And Father, we declare and decree that she has faith to drive. She has no fear. She trusts in you, Lord, that you are guiding and directing her, Lord, that you are her passenger, that you are in the car wherever she goes, Lord, in the name of Jesus. And I declare and decree that no weapon formed against Tina can prosper in the name of Jesus. Amen.
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 Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank
you. Tina, just say, I'm free in Jesus' name.
I am free in Jesus' name. I will drive in the freeway in Jesus' name.
Amen.
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 All right. Anybody else need prayer tonight?
Amen. I just that same prayer. I need to get my driver's license and, fear.
Oh, I'm amazed all these Christians don't have fear in Jesus' name. I'm going to speak positive. Okay, so this is obviously a tactic of the enemy these days. All right, let's just do this for everyone on the prayer line right now, everybody on the conference call and those on the Facebook that might be facing anxiety in an area or fear. And let's just pray together. You know, the Bible says perfect love casts out fear. And God says without faith, it's impossible to please him. So we've got to operate in faith. So let's just all decree this. It may sound like a bunch of gobbledygook doing it together, but that's okay. But let's all just make this declaration. Just say, I am free.
I am free.
I am free.
From the spirit of fear.
I am free.
From the spirit of fear.
All right. Say, spirit of fear.
Spirit.
Go in Jesus' name.
Go. Sheets of anxiety, get up and go.
Amen. Now, everybody, all of us praying together, we've got power. So we've got to say, in Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
I am free.
I am free.
From the spirit of fear. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
All right. Awesome. Praise God. You keep me posted, Sharon, how you're doing.
Praise God.
All right. Did anybody else have any prayer for anybody else need prayer for healing tonight?
I do.
And who is that? I can't see.
This is Betty Jane. My throat is still bothering me.
Betty Jane, okay. All right.
At different times of the day, so it's, you know, it's hard to swallow sometimes.
Okay, sure. All right, just put your hand on your throat. Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we just speak healing to Betty Jane's throat right now. We command any swelling to go, any infection to go. We curse it. Father, we thank you that her throat functions the way you created it to function. We speak life into her throat right now in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name, that her throat will function the way you created it to function now in Jesus' name. Okay, take a couple of swallows, Betty Jane, and tell me how you feel.
Okay.
Do you feel any difference?
I don't.
You don't?
I don't, but I'm working on it. We're working on it.
It's okay. Sometimes people feel it right away, and sometimes they don't. But we're just going to be in agreement, all of us, just be in agreement that Betty Jean is healed completely. And we thank you, Lord, for her miracle by faith in Jesus' name.
She is healed.
In Jesus' name.
Yes.
She is healed.
Amen. Okay, is there anybody else that needs prayer for healing? Okay.
Kurt.
Who is that?
It's Peter Gay. Peter Gay.
Okay.
He's from my mind.
Okay. All right. So, Father, in the name of Jesus, we just speak clarity of mind over Peter Gay. We command all confusion to go from her in Jesus' name.
Yes.
We declare and decree she has the mind of Christ. In the name of Jesus, all fear and anxiety has to go in Jesus' name.
Go.
Depression, you have to go in Jesus' name. Spirit of grief, you have to go in Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
We speak freedom over Peter Gay's life. And we say she's free. In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Confusion has to go in Jesus' name. Does anybody on the team get anything for, let's just press in for Peter Gay, and if anyone gets anything to minister to her, to go ahead and do that. Peter, are you back in Homestead now?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, you're in Homestead? Okay. Father, we just lift up Peter Gay, and we just thank you, Lord, for a word of encouragement for her, Lord, in the name of Jesus.
Jesus.
In the name of Jesus. Jesus. Father, I just come against every demonic spirit that is just the heaviness over her, Lord. We just break the heaviness. We break all demonic assignments, mind-binding spirits, and we cancel their power against her in Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Anyone on the team get anything for Peter Gay? Peter Gay, I just wanted to tell you, so I just saw like a dark cloud over you. And so I just prayed against it, but I just feel led to tell you just to speak the word over you, you know, speak clarity of mind over you, speak to, the demonic spirits that are trying to oppress you and command them to go. I know that's difficult when you don't feel good, but that's what you need to do. Okay.
This is Desiree, and I just heard the word vice, V-I-C-E, like a
vice grip. Yeah. I saw the same thing. Okay. Anybody else for Peter Gay?
This is Sarah, and I just heard the word regret.
Regret. Okay. So the Lord doesn't want you to have regret. Okay, Peter Gay?
Yes, ma'am.
Anybody else for Peter Gay? Father, we just thank you for healing Peter Gay's heart. Father, we thank you that you are the great physician, Lord. And Lord, we just ask you to go into her heart and just heal the pain. Father, to make her whole once again. Father, we thank you that no weapon against Peter Gay can prosper. Father, we thank you that you can heal emotional pain to where you leave no scar. So, Father, we thank you for healing and restoring Peter Gay. We thank you for strengthening her by your Spirit. And, Father, that she will just give her supernatural strength while she goes through this grieving process, Lord, that she will be able to make it through to the other side and have victory in you. Because of who she is, Lord, and who she is, in Jesus' name. Amen.
In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Anybody else?
Just Aaron and my kids.
Okay. So let's... What was that, Aaron?
Just for the gum and teeth, but also for, like, we have swollen toes, so I don't know.
Okay. So Father, in Jesus' name, we just lift up Aaron and her kids. Father, we ask you to heal the swelling in their bodies, Lord, once and for all, Lord. We ask you to heal their gums and their teeth, Lord, that they will, Lord, have no pain or soreness in their gums or teeth. Father, we thank you for showing them what's causing this, Lord, in the name of Jesus, Lord. We just declare and decree, we stand in agreement. Father, you say that we have an unction from the Holy One and we know all things. And I thank you, Lord, that you are showing Aaron and her children what's the cause of this, Lord. And they're getting to the root problem in Jesus' name. Aaron, sometimes those types of things happen with not having the nutrients, the proper nutrients that you need, minerals. I'm just telling you that that's something that I know of. Okay, anybody else need prayer for healing tonight?
Yes, ma'am. My name is Tracy Phillips, and I was calling for prayer.
Okay. Tracy, where are you calling in from?
Ballin?
Louisiana. Okay. All right. And your name is Tracy, correct?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So tell me again what I can pray for you for.
Yes, ma'am. I'm just calling to pray for me because I've been having, like breakouts. Every now and then, a breakout on my face, like a rash.
Okay.
And I don't know where it comes from. And I just want you to pray for me and ask the Lord, you know, whatever's going on to remove it.
Sure.
Any type of sickness, any type of disease, and just heal my body, you know.
Sure. All right.
Heal me.
Mm-hmm. Sure. Let's all stand in agreement, team. And then students, if we could press in and pray for her just to see if we get anything. Father, in Jesus' name, we just lift up Tracy Phillips right now, Lord. Father, we thank you that she's your child. And Father, your word says that that you wish above all things that Tracy is in health, even as her soul prospers. And so, Father, we just lift up Tracy right now, the problems that she's having with her skin. And we ask you, Lord, to show her where that what the root cause of that is, Lord, if it's emotions or if it's something she's eating. Father, we ask you to reveal it to her, to give her the wisdom. If it's a cream, a new cream that she's using, or a new soap that may be causing this. But Father, we ask you to give her clarity and wisdom, Lord, in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus,
Lord. Father, your word says if we ask for wisdom, you'll give it to us liberally and unabridedeth not. So, Father, I ask you to give her wisdom in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Any of the students, if you have anything for her, to go ahead and release it.
This is Joshua. Yes, I felt to pray to break the back of that.
Okay, go ahead. Joshua, it's hard to hear you. Your phone's going in and out. If you can maybe...
Yes.
There, I can hear that now. Go ahead.
Yes, I felt to pray to break the back of that that has afflicted her. In the name of Jesus, we come for Sister Stacy in the name of Jesus, and we break the back of those breakouts. In the name of Jesus, we break the back of it in the name of Jesus, in Jesus' name. Thank you, Heavenly Father. We declare in Jesus' name that now it's broken, in Jesus' name, and we release healing, in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you, Pastor Joshua. All right. Anybody else need prayer tonight for healing?
Yes, I would like prayer. My name's Raven. I want some prayer today. I know we've all prayed about emotional and healing and all that, so I was just wanting to pray about wavering and doubting.
Okay. We normally just leave Monday nights for healing, but I'll pray for you. Father, in Jesus' name, Lord, we just ask you, Lord, to help Raven to stay rooted and grounded in trust and faith in you, Lord, that she will not waver, but she will trust that you honor your word. Lord, that you're not 1 minute early or 1 minute late, but you're right on time. And Father, that she will continue to give thanks and praise until it manifests in the natural realm. And Father, that she's confident of this very thing, that he that has begun a good work will perform it until the day of Jesus Christ. So, Father, I just speak that over Raven, and I thank you, Lord, that she trusts in you, Lord, and believes your word in Jesus' name. Raven, I just felt led to tell you, don't look at your circumstances. Look at what God's word says about your situation. And you just keep thanking him about your situation, what you want, not what the circumstance says. I don't know what it is that you're facing or what you're wavering about, but I know that the enemy is putting little things around you to get your eyes off the path so that you get in depression or you lose hope. And God wants you to stay focused on what you're believing for. Amen?
Amen.
What are you wavering about?
I mean, it could be anything, but like even like we were like I listened to you preach today, and you were saying you got to build that your strong man up because you know how you said the grape. I know it's something you used a metaphor, but I thought that was kind of powerful because it's like anything I can hear. Like I don't watch the news, I don't do that, but I can hear anybody's story, and I can get sad about their story, and then I'll take on the burden. And it's like I'm trying to figure out, like, how do I keep casting those cares because I can't carry people's burdens.
Right. But you just ask God to release you of that because you obviously have a sensitivity in the spirit to feel what other people feel. I have the same thing, but I'm released from it. You know, like I get it to pray for the person, and then I pray for him and it's gone. So you probably are picking up
depression, but it's only being hearing other people's situation. Like someone told me yesterday about a lady in the mental health. I mean, I literally carried that. So
well, you just have to pray. What you do is pray about the person, and then you release it to the Lord, and then it'll go off of you. You're just carrying it because you haven't dealt with it. Does that make sense?
Amen.
In other words, you have compassion for the person. So you hear the story, you have compassion, you're grieving, but you're forgetting you need to, the reason you're grieving is because God has given you that compassion to say, hey, Raven, pray for him. And then when you pray for him and you release it to God, it'll go away. But if you don't, it stays on you because God wants you to pray. That's how he speaks to us.
Amen.
Or that's how he speaks to you because you have that compassion.
Amen.
Okay. All right.
Martiel?
Go ahead.
It's very similar to when, I don't know how long you've been on to the meeting, Raven, but part of the thing Martiel was talking about was the practicing, practice. What she's talking about, the burden bearing, is a practice and a discipline. So it's when you give it to the Lord, and it's a practice, part of your prayer lifestyle. It comes on you, but you give it. And so in the practicing of knowing what to do with it, his yoke and his burdens are easy. His burdens are light. There's a transfer. So you're going to become lighter in the process. Amen.
Yes, good word. All right, anybody else need prayer for healing, or want prayer for healing, I should say? Okay, awesome. Let's see if there's anyone on Facebook tonight. All right. Okay, so nobody else needs prayer for healing. All right, well, it's getting a little late, so I'm just going to pray a quick prayer over everybody in case people do have needs for healing. But we all can use healing, I'm sure.
There's one person, excuse me, Martina.
Yes?
There's one person that was on from, I believe it's North Carolina, 70499. They didn't identify themselves.
But they wanted prayer for healing? Is that what you're saying?
I don't know, but it's just
Okay.
Lone Ranger.
Okay, the person that's on from 704 area code, did you need prayer? Would you like to introduce yourself? Yes, no, maybe so. Okay. Well, we want everyone to introduce themselves when they come on the conference call so we know who is in our group. Can you introduce yourself at area code 704?
999.
Okay, well, they didn't want to. Okay, so for whatever reason, who knows? Okay, so anyway, so is there anyone else that needed prayer? Okay, just want to make sure I got everybody. Okay, so thank you everyone for coming in on Facebook tonight, and for everybody that came in on the conference call tonight, we appreciate it. We are here every Monday night for an evening in the supernatural. I just want to thank God in advance for all the miracles that he has done Amen. Tonight. I know a couple Amen. Of you received healing and felt better, Amen. So thank God. We appreciate his faithfulness to his word. And I want to thank everyone for coming out, and I just want to pray a prayer over everyone that God will just keep us whole. So, Father, in Jesus' name, Lord, I just lift up everyone on Facebook and in this conference call tonight. Father, I just plead the blood of Jesus over each one of us, your protection, your angels to be encamped around about each one of us. And, Father, I just declare and decree your word over our lives, Father, that the steps of the righteous are ordered of the Lord. And, Father, that you're ordering our steps and our path and making it sure. Father, I thank you for wisdom, Lord, that you're giving each of us wisdom for the decisions that we have to make, Father, for the situations that we're faced with. Father, for health reasons, Lord, that you're showing us what we need to do to get better. Lord, how to eat, how to exercise. But Father, I just pray, Lord, that you will continue to open the doors you want open for us and close the doors you want shut. Father, I pray that each one of us will fulfill our destinies in you, Lord, that we all are children of the Most High God. And Father, that we will not only fulfill our natural occupations, but our spiritual occupations. Father, that we will come to know what you're calling us to do for our spiritual walk on earth. And I pray this in Jesus' name, Father. And I thank you that each person will sleep soundly tonight, Lord. And Father, will wake up refreshed and full of energy tomorrow as they press on to work and do all the things that they need to do. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
All right. Amen. So thank you, everyone, for coming out. I appreciate it, everybody on Facebook. Y'all could say goodbye to everyone on Facebook. Good night.
Good night, everyone.
Yes, God bless.
I'm so glad I found this ministry. Thank you, God.
You're welcome. We appreciate you coming on, Tina. Look forward to praying with you some more. All right, so thank you, everyone. Philip and Desiree and Betty Jane and Peter Gay and Ricky. All right. All right, God bless everyone. Thank you for coming out.
God bless.
All right. God bless. And thank you, everyone on Facebook. Thank you for joining in. Have a great evening, and we'll see you next Monday at 9 p.m. God bless.
Amen. God bless. God bless. God bless.